turnovers. Tough night for DeMarcus last night, but you know that what's great, Neil? The guys were giving him a hard time of, you know, goodness, you know. How can you play that poorly, you know? And so I expect him to come out and play well tonight.
Murray State 4-1, Weber State 3-2 for the championship. We will be back with the starting lineups after this on the Racer Sports Network. Test. Murray State going against Weber State, and here's what we have for you. First of all, for Weber State, out of the Big Sky, they come in at 3-2, and at center it'll be Joel Ballenboy. He is a 6'9 junior out of Fort Worth, Texas. Comes in averaging 16.2 points, 12 rebounds per game, the third leading rebounder in the nation last season. At guard, it is McKay Cannon. Cannon is a 6'4 freshman. He hails from Shelley, Idaho. Cannon averages 8 points and 2.6 rebounds per game. Also at guard, Jeremy Singlin, coming off a fabulous 34-point game last night, a career high. Singlin is a 6'2 junior out of Arlington, Texas, averaging 22 points per contest and 4.2 rebounds per game. At forward, Dusty Baker. Baker is a 6'4 sophomore who averages 5.8 points and 2 rebounds per game. Baker hails from Coto de la Casa, California. And at forward, it's Zach Braxton. Braxton is a 6'9 freshman out of Highlands Ranch, Colorado, averages 4.4 points and 3.4 rebounds per game. Randy Ray is the head coach in his 10th season at Weber State, 185 wins, 106 losses, a four-time Big Sky Coach of the Year, 7 postseason tournaments in 10 years, 5 20-win seasons, and had that big 30-7 season back in the 2012-2013 year. Murray State will counter with this starting lineup for the Racers. At one guard, it'll be Bryce Jones. Jones is a 6'4 junior who hails from Brooklyn, New York, averages 8.6 points and 4.4 rebounds per game. Part of a four-guard offense is DeMarcus Croker, a 6'2 junior from Orlando, Florida, averaging 11.2 points and 5 rebounds per contest. Jeffrey Moss is a 6'4 senior from Madison, Alabama. He's at guard, averaging 10.6 points and 3.2 rebounds per game. And G. McGee, the fourth guard. McGee is a 6'5 junior out of Baton Rouge, Louisiana, averaging 9 points and 4.2 rebounds per game. And Wayne Langston is the forward. He's a 6'7 senior from Washington, D.C., who averages 13.6 points and 4.2 rebounds per game. Matt McMahon on the bench throughout the Steve Frome era, moves down a seat. He's the head coach, 4-1, as are the Racers here in the early season. Weber State averages 77 points a game, gives up 67.2. They are plus 3.2 on the boards. The Wildcats shoot 48% from the field, 40% from three-point range. They defend 41% from the field and 36% behind the arc, and they hit 68% of their free throws. For the Racers, 71.6 point per game average. They're giving up 60.2, minus 3.4 on the boards. That has been an issue for them. 44% from the field, 31% from three range, but they're defending at a great rate, 35% from the field and just 30% from three-point range at the line. Not a great night last night, but they are at 70% on the year. Murray State going up against Weber State. Kenny, I wanted to ask you one thing. Matt McMahon was telling us, and it's a statistic there. It's in the OVC stats. If you'll go up and look at that, it's rebound percentage, not rebound margin. Matt says kind of the modern day thing. They're not all that concerned with rebound margin. It's rebound percentage. And he says the Racers fare much better when you take a look at it from that standpoint.
Right. I think when you look at the number of offensive rebounds that the other team is getting as a percentage of total shots missed, that is the part of the statistic that they're looking at that's closer and feels like our percentage there is, you know, could be better, but not at a horrible place. And so, and he said, you know, we're not going to out-rebound a lot of people. He said, you know, we're just small, but he said we've got to rebound on the defensive end. We've got to keep people off the offensive glass because he said, I don't know that we're ever going to be a great offensive rebounding team.
However, even he said they need to get more than two per game. And you don't win many when you only get two, but they did a lot of things so well last night, they were able to overcome that.
They were, and I think DeMarcus Croker is a guy that, you know, should be worked the offensive glass pretty hard. G. McGee should be a guy. You know, Jeffrey Moss, all those guys are very athletic wing players that could go in and get one or two offensive boards, you know, a game. The one thing about tonight, Neil, with Weber State, is their transition from defense to offense happens very quickly. And the bigs run the floor well. And so the Racers, if they are going to attack the offensive glass, they got to be ready to get back in a hurry as Weber State will push the basketball.
The Wildcats in the purple shirts and shorts. They are the visiting team on the scoreboard. They have white numerals. Names across the back. Weber across the top of the numbers. State across the bottom. Murray State in their traditional white shirts, white shorts with navy and gold trim. Murray across the top of the numeral and State across the bottom. No names on the back for the Racers, but they do have that horseshoe symbol sitting above the number. Wayne Langston will jump it at 6'7". He goes up against Joel Ballenboy. 6'9 against 6'7". Weber State should have an advantage here, but Wayne Langston with the double tip gets the tip. And in the backcourt, it is McGee. Off to Jones. Jones comes across the center stripe with a left-hand dribble. Hands it off to Croker. He works the point. Looks left side for Moss. Dribbles once. He wants Jones to come out. Hands it off to him. Down to the near corner it goes to Moss. Down on the low block. They double down on Langston. It's a kick into the corner to Croker. He drives. Puts the shot up. No good. And on the rebound, it's tipped out. Racers have it. It comes to Moss inside the free throw line. He put it up and in.
Moved the ball over to his right hand, Niels. He drove the gap. Interesting to see that on the entrance pass into the post to Wayne Langston, the double team came very quickly.
Cannon hooks it right side, caught by Braxton, who gets it away to Singlin. He's a guy that had the hot hand last night. I mean, just a terrific game. To the left, it comes to Braxton, down on the low block. Braxton tries to back down his defender, throws it to Cannon into the right corner, a shot fake. Now top of the key three by Cannon, front of the rim, and it is off. Rebound by Wayne Langston. And the Racers have a two-point lead in the ball. We played a minute. And the man pressure applied by Weber State. Moss to the top, comes to Croker. One bounces to Moss into the far corner. Back to Croker on the right side. To the near side down to Jones. Checks Matt McMahon for some signals. Now dribbles at the point. Shovels it to Croker in the paint. Fadeaway on the double team. Banked it in.
Athletic move by DeMarcus Croker as he attacked the gap, but came under control, and that was a point of discussion, is to go to a good jump stop, Neil, and go straight up and straight down.
Ballenboy has it on the right wing, finds Cannon at the top, left side Singlin, lobs it back to Cannon into the right corner, gets the lob from Baker. on the baseline to Ballenboy. Fadeaway 15-footer rattles off. The Racers get the rebound. G. McGee will bring it across the center stripe. One bounces it to Jones. Takes it into the paint, cradles it, throws up a crazy shot that's slapped out of there by Ballenboy. Picked up by Singlin, who'll get the breakaway layup, and Weber State is on the board.
Defensively, the Racers are doing a good job on Ballenboy, is here, forcing him to be a jump shooter. The Racers are okay if he faces up and wants to shoot that 15-footer. It's just catching it with 2 feet in the paint that's a problem defensively.
Jones at the point, hits Langston down to the near corner. Fade away from 17, Moss hit another one. A hot start for Jeffrey Moss, who has four, 6-2 Racers. Cannon will bring it across the mid-stripe. He has a black sleeve covering his right arm. One bounces it away to Singlin, looking to get his shot. Hedged by Langston, forces to give it up to Cannon. Down low, that's going to be an easy one off the glass and in for Braxton.
Braxton, big, strong, 6'9", and G. McGee having a tough time fronting him and keeping the ball out of the post.
6-4 Racers on top. We played nearly 3 minutes. Jones has it at the top, finds Moss on the wing in front of the Weber State bench. It comes to McGee, back to Moss, gets the defender in the air, shoots the 17-footer and missed it, and on the rebound, it's pulled out of there by Braxton. Outlet to the left side, Singlin. To the near side, it comes back to Cannon. Left elbow toss to Singlin. Has freedom at the top, decides not to shoot. Right wing, three in the air, and good by Baker, and Weber State is up 7-6.
Dusty Baker, we knew could shoot the basketball, but surprised that he pulled that trigger with someone right in his face.
And he's hitting 15% behind the arc. He's a good three-point shooter who's off to a bad start. And he may be getting uncranked. Out top, this is Jones driving in. We'll get a hand check call. The basket will be waved off. It was before the shot. And Weber State with the personal, I believe, it'll be McKay Cannon. And it is Cannon with the foul.
Coach McMahon talked to the Racer team about not letting the ball stay in your hands too long. Either make a play or send it on and get that ball reversed.
Jones left side, catch and shoot three is nothing but net by G. McGee. A 30% three-point shooter puts the Racers up 9-7.
See if the Racers can get better ball pressure, Neil, as they're trying to feed the post.
Gannon right side to Baker, drives in through two defenders, lost the ball. Touch last by Croker, who couldn't handle it, and that'll get us to our first media timeout. Murray State a 9-7 lead with 15:58 to go. Back after this on the Racers Sports Network. Trucks, cars, SUVs, and vans. Details and pictures of each are online at PerkinsMotorplex.com. Shop today at Perkins Motorplex in Murray, Mayfield, Paducah, and Nashville, or online anytime at PerkinsMotorplex.com. Early thoughts, Kenny?
Well, one of the points of emphasis on the scouting report was for Jeffrey Moss to do his work defensively before Jeremy Singlin catches the ball. So far, Singlin hasn't had any open looks at all.
Singlin gets the lob on the pass out of bounds out front. Gets it away to Baker. He'll bring it out top of the key. Looks left side. Finds Singlin. Quick release on the three, and he hit another one.
I jinxed us on that one, Neil, as he was falling away, and Bryce Jones was was in his drawers with him, and he still was able to hit the shot.
Five for Sigland. Weber State regains the lead 10-9. Curl pass goes to Langston down low. Across the lane, finds Broker, went up for the shot, and lost the ball out of bounds.
Yeah, he was by himself, Neil. The double team came. He stormed down the baseline for a good cut to the basket, caught the ball, and just lost it out of bounds.
Racer turnover is there first. Into the corner it goes to Baker. He looks inside, now fires into the corner to Singlin, who waves everybody out top. Moss is on him, gets it away now to Cannon. To the left side, it's Baker inside. Tough shot, missed it, tipped out. Chased down by Wayne Langston. A 3-on-2 break for the Racers. Jones cradles, shoots, and hits the layup.
Bryce Jones had Wayne Langston running the right wing and made the correct decision not to give it to the big guy in traffic and take it himself and be able to convert the layup.
Every starter except Langston has scored. He was the Racers' leading scorer last night. 11-10 Murray, 14-49. Out top, there's Singlin, another three, and he hit it. You can't give him daylight. He'll bury it. He has eight, and it's 13-11 Weber State. Right side, Jones comes left, swings it with a one hand to Moss. Moss looks back to Langston, finds himself free, missed the jumper, and then tosses it off Singlin's leg out of bounds. A good play by Jeffrey Moss.
This is a veteran referee crew tonight, Neil, led by Teddy Valentine and OVC ref Brent Hampton. And this will be a crew that's not going to blow their whistle a lot. So when you're driving the lane, you got to go strong. And you've got to make sure that you have an opportunity to score because they're not going to bail you out with a call.
Croker out, Colbreth in at that dead ball. As Jones dribbles right side, we have Colbreth lurking in the near corner. They whip it right side to Moss, steps inside by the defender and buries the 16-foot jumper.
Jeffrey Moss is having his way with Jeremy Singlin as he is going for every one of Jeffrey Moss's ball fakes. Moss is able to create some space and score.
Tied at 13 as we approach the 14-minute mark. Gittins checked in at the dead ball for Weber State. Drive inside for Bottomboy. And a reaching foul called against the Racers will mean two shots for Weber State.
They brought Bottomboy out high there and set a high screen. And as he released to go to the basket, it's difficult for Wayne Langston to be able to recover and keep that pass from occurring. G. McGee had to come over and help and got called on the foul.
Bollenboy has a special set of skills. He scores, he rebounds. He can even hit the three, 38%, but he doesn't shoot free throws well yet, 54%, and he misses that first one badly off the left side of the rim, but he has a chance to get one here.
Two NBA scouts in the building again tonight to watch this young man.
Next one, back of the iron, no good, and Wayne Langston clears, and the Racers with a chance to regain the lead. Under 14 minutes left of the first half. Langston out top, gets the hand off to Colbreth. Right side to McGee. Splits two defenders, forced the action that time and missed the shot. Back of the iron and rebound by Weber State. Singlin hands it on the wing. Out top, Bollenboy thought of a three. Instead goes left side to Cannon. Looking for Singlin, nearly fell into Colbreth. Finds Singlin right side, looks to create some space. Bounces mid-block, extended. Bollenboy faces his defender. Spin move, he traveled with it. He did not expect the double team, Kenny.
No, he didn't, and that was part of the scout report, is to help and recover. Not completely come with the double team, but show, and then if he puts it on the floor, the Racer perimeter is digging in, Neil, trying to get that ball out of there.
And one of his signature moves is to spin, get by his man, and stuff it.
He loves that right shoulder spin, and he spun on the right shoulder right into the Racer help defense.
We have Sanchez into the game as McGee checks out. Colbreth and Jones play catch out front. Left side it comes on the wing to Moss to the top. Now to Colbreth. He looks left side, dribbles. We have 11 on the shot clock as Colbreth backs it out. Now down to 8 on the shot clock. Colbreth top of the key, 3, rims off hard, and it's Baker with the rebound. That's Cannon across the center stripe. Cannon left side, elbow jump pass, comes to Hill, puts it up, missed it, but contact will mean more free throws for Weber State.
Breon Sanctius into the game now for the Racers and just got caught a little bit off balance there and had to foul as Hill was going to the basket.
As poor as Bollenboy is at the line, 54%. Kendall Hill is that good, the 6'7 junior and 87% free throw shooter. And as you might expect, he hits the first of two.
Hill has a great motor on the offensive glass. Last night we watched him as he continued attack that offensive glass to get loose balls for this Weber State team.
The Wildcats up one and a chance to go up two if Hill can sink the second one. That one rims out, but Langston grabs the rebound. Off to Bryce Jones, 12:45 left in the half. Weber State a 14-13 lead, and they've switched defenses now. Out front, it's Jones. Left-hand dribble gets a screen from Sanchez into the corner to Colbert. Back to Jones. Skip pass to Croker for three, and it's back of the iron. No good. His shooting woes continue. Ball goes loose on the floor, picked up by Sanglin, and he's able to get it away and get it back. He'll bring it across the center stripe. Looks at a matchup issue against Colbert, who reached in and got him on the arm. Then a little bit of a push, and he got teed up for that. But not much of a push, but he gave him a little bit of an elbow that sometimes officials will let that go. Sometimes they want. That time they didn't, Kenny.
A good call. I was watching, and Brent Hampton was right on top of it. As Chad Colbert causes those kind of problems, Neil, he is just like a gnat. I mean, he is working so hard defensively, and he did reach in and foul, and you could tell that Singlin doesn't like it. And he gave him a little forearm shiver there and got called for it. Good call.
There's no doubt that Colbert, he got a little anxious trying to bother Singlin and got him on the arm. So he's guilty of the foul, but first of all, we'll take care of the technical as Bryce Jones will step to the stripe. Jones, a 90% free throw shooter. Jeffrey Moss, usually who you would choose, but he's not on the floor at this moment.
Right.
So the best available free throw shooter on the floor is Jones. It is up and good. Jones will get one more. 3 points for Jones, six for Moss, two for Croker, three for McGee. Singlin once again leading Weber State. He has eight. Baker with three, Braxton with two, and Hill off the bench for one. Jones with a very deliberate, takes a little bit of a practice motion with his left hand and then pops the second free throw. And now we'll come to the other end. It'll be the Racers' ball. So that was just going to be a common foul. The Racers have a chance to get 4 or 5 points out of this, Kenny.
You can see Bryce Jones starting to feel confidence, Neil. He's been in the program now 2 or 3 months, and you can just see now as he's starting to talk and lead this basketball team on the floor.
Randy Ray not happy with the call. Clapping his hands, looking at Brett Hampton on the sideline. Very unhappy. Sanchez, 15-foot jumper. He hit it!
Breon Sanchez squared those shoulders, Neil. They work on those shots every day. A 15-foot square-up shot. Nice shot by the freshman.
17-14 the score. Out top, Gittins to the baseline. It's a jumper by Gittins, and it rattles around, falls out. Sanchez tips it to McGee. One on three, takes it in anyway. Shouldn't have done that and missed the shot. Just a really bad possession. Singlin to the left side. Stop and pop 15-footer. It is good. Off the bench, John Cody knocking that one down. And another one of those bad shots. Racers had a bucket full of those last night.
G. McGee had a route to the basket, but he just took off too quick.
Inside, Colbert banks it in. Got by the defender like he did last night and hits one from about 8 feet.
Chad Colbert's not scared. You can see he's got a lot of confidence in his game, and he's just got to now play without fouling. He's got that early foul.
19-16 Racers, another new player in. Hang on. We have a whistle away from the ball.
Breon Sanchez pushing in the post on Ballenboy.
That'll be his second. That'll get us to our next media timeout. Our score, 19-16 Murray State with 11:04 to go in the half. Back after this on the Racer Sports Network. State up three. The Racers shooting 50%. That's good. Weber State even better, 60% from the field. The Racers and the Weber State one turnover each, so they've been very clean as far as that goes. And the Wildcats have the ball underneath out of bounds, left side of the basket. It'll be singling to inbound it, poked away by Chad Colbreth out of the hands of Cody John.
One number on the stat sheet that is appealing for the Racers in the first 9 minutes is zero offensive rebounds by Weber State at this point. Neil doing a good job on the defensive glass.
Singlin near the mid-stripe. He one bounces it to Gittins. To the right wing, Hill stop off the mid-block and banked it in. That was a sweet shot. To make that shot without fouling says a lot about the skill set of Kendall Hill. Inside, they find Langston wide open, and he put it up and in.
Bryce Jones with a bullet pass from mid-court as the Wildcats were in some type of half-court trap, like a 1-3-1, and Bryce Jones beat it single-handedly.
Racers back up three, 10.5 minutes remaining in the half. Gittins guarded by Jones, left-hand dribble. Cross-court skip pass comes to Sanglin out top, guarded by Croker now. Back to the right side, Gittins inside, jumps, misses, and will get a foul, an on-the-elbow called against Bryce Jones. And that'll be two more free throws for Weber State.
Gittins is a great athlete for Weber State and talked about he likes to drive the basketballs. He went baseline there and caused the Racers some problems.
33% free throw shooter, but not much of a sample size this early on. And that one is up and good. 21-19. Racers actually out-rebounding Weber State 8-6. Despite two 6'9 players in the starting lineup. The next one up and good. So not bad for a 33% free throw shooter. And it's 21-20. Here comes that three-quarter court pressure again. Jump pass. McGee to Croker. Man, that's dangerous. Make your heart skip a beat when a player of your team does that. McGee comes out to Colbreth at the top. Jones out of the game, by the way. Colbreth open for a heartbeat from three. Didn't want it. Finds Croker back to Colbreth. He wants that three, and he missed it badly. Side of the rim, tipped out of bounds off McGee. It'll go to Weber State. They'll have a chance to go up.
Well, the box was checked there by the freshman mistake. We can count on one game from Chad Colbreth, and taking that three early in the shot clock, Neil, is not exactly what Coach McMahon was looking for in trying to attack that zone.
Singlin to the right side finds Hill. Hill looks for the lob. One bounces it out to Gittins. Looks left. Colbreth has the man covered up, forced to get it away to Singlin. Singlin guarded by Jeffrey Moss, who checked back in at the dead ball. Looks left. Singlin right. Tipped away by Colbreth. John's able to save it. Five on the shot clock. Singlin notices that. Step back three is no good. Good steal by Croker. Racers play that one well. Off to Colbreth. Colbreth left side to Moss. Finds Croker. Back to Colbreth. And they will reset the offense here with 9:15 remaining in the half. Murray State a 21-20 lead. Colbreth attacks. Shovels it to Croker. It's a handoff to McGee. Back to Croker. Baseline 15-footer. Side of the rim no good. Croker couldn't get the rebound. And we had a couple players tangled up. It'll be a foul called against Weber State. And it appears Cody John a little shaken up on the play.
Marcus Croker took the mid-range jumper, Neil, and as soon as his feet hit the floor, he was going towards the offensive glass to try to get that board, and would have had it and probably scored if he hadn't gotten fouled.
Inbounds pass goes into the far corner to Moss, out top to Croker, back to Moss on the far sideline. Mid-block extended. They doubled down on McGee to Colbreth. Jump pass to Moss. Couldn't get his feet squared to shoot that three. Finds Croker at the top. He's ice cold from three range, rejects it. He pushed off with the elbow, and that's a good call.
Sure is. Good call. DeMarcus Croker driving the lane. And, you know, one of the things that Coach McMahon talked about is he is constantly, this Racer offense is spread the floor and trying to drive the lane. But he made the point that you're not required to shoot it, Neil, when you drive the lane. You know, you can drive it and kick it, and there – DeMarcus Croker should have gone ahead and drive that gap and kicked it out to the wing.
Racers giving up 58% shooting from the field tonight, but they've taken 19 shots to just 12 for the Wildcats. Out top, it's Hill. Comes away to Cannon. Curls at the top, guarded by Colbreth. Back to the left side, John holds the ball above his head, hits Cannon between the circles. 10 on the shot clock. Racers making him work for it. Back to John on the wing. jump pass at the elbow. Left corner three is up and good by Cannon, and that's his first points of the game. Weber State up 23-21. Moss has it left side as the Racers couldn't get anything easy. Good recovery. Nice inside. That'll be a goaltend. It didn't matter. It went in anyway. And it's a great feed from Colbert to Langston for the bucket.
It sure was. And that's a difficult post pass from where he was at the top of the key. But he was able to weave it through there. Wayne Langston caught it. And they quick off the floor able to get that to go.
Hill comes out of the game. And we see Ballenboy back in. He's been held scoreless to this point. But Singlin has done the big bulk of the damage with eight. Up against a media timeout, dribbled off the toe of Gittins, defended well by the Racers, and that'll lead to a turnover. It gives it back to Murray State when we come back out of the media timeout. Tied at 23 with 7:53 left in the half. Back after this on the Racer Sports Network. For the big cow. 23 all, 7:53 to go. Kenny, we see Justin Seymour in.
Looks like the Weber State is going to stay in this zone, which is kind of a 1-3-1 setup that they're in.
Goes to Seymour, right side, corner, three, Moss buried it. Jeffrey Moss having a big half. He has nine, and the Razors back on top, 26-23. Canada across the center stripe. Guarded by Jones, one bounce comes to John. He looks right side. It's Baker, mid block, going in. Ballenboy banked it in and out, but he gets the rebound, had it swatted out. This may go against Langston, and that's your prime example of what Ballenboy can do. He has that long reach, was able to get over and grab the ball.
He was, and you know, the ball looked like it was going down. And I think Wayne, you know, almost was ready to pull out because he thought the basket was good, and Ballenboy was able to go over the top and snatch that offensive glass.
First foul against Wayne Langston sends Ballenboy to the line. Missed his only two attempts earlier, but he knocks down this one, the first of two, for his first point of the game. And the Racer lead cut to two. Ballenboy second in the air. It's also good. 26-25. Racers have it. Jones, Croker, Moss, Langston, Seymour in the game. Jones looks top of the key to Croker. Back to Jones, lobs it to Langston down low. Seymour catch and shoot, 17-footer in and out. And the rebound pulled out by Ballenboy. Off to Cannon. Gets it to Braxton. Braxton to the right side, John. Down low it goes to Ballenboy. Face up 15-footer is no good. Good seal there by Seymour. To hand it to Jones, and the Racers clinging to that one-point lead. Croker on the far side. We get a whistle away from the ball, and I believe this may go against Ballenboy for trying to hook Langston.
Wayne Langston working hard on the quick post-up in the secondary fast break, and Ballenboy was trying to fight around and got the foul.
Sanchez has two fouls, and that's the only player for either team with more than one. Out top, it is Jones, right side to Moss, who's been hot, to the baseline. They double down Langston, hits the net with it, but as it turned out, it slowed it down enough for Coker to catch it and stuff it for a Dunkin' Donuts dunk shot.
And it's a good thing, Neil, that ball was going to be 10 rows up. It was sailing past Croker, and he was able to catch it and put it in.
28-25. John bounces it into the corner. Dangerous pass, but Baker's able to get it out. Now to Cannon. 9 on the shot clock as Cannon dribbles out top. Looks down low for Braxton. Beats his man, but left it off the side of the rim. No good. Rebounded out by Seymour. Off to Jones in transition. Takes it in. Put it up. Missed the shot. Gets it back. Shovels it to Moss, who curls it to nobody. Passed it to himself, and you can't do that. That's a turnover.
No, and there's an example of Bryce Jones driving in, Neil, really with, you know, you're not going to get that call. I mean, this veteran crew is not going to give that call. And Bryce just went too deep and got a shot blocked, so a turnover on the Racers.
It's been an issue in the Racers in this tournament a lot last night and not as much tonight a couple of times, once by Croker, now once by Jones. And I think McGee, to the right side it comes to Cannon. He's between the circles, he looks right side. Been a while since we've heard from Singlin. Singlin bounces it down low, mid-block. Ballaboy tries to post up, and he's fouled. That was a no-doubter there as Langston got him across the wrist. But that'll be the second foul on Wayne Langston.
Boy, those reach-in fouls there. You hope Wayne would just slide his feet over and put his hands straight up, and if Ballaboy hits a shot, he hits a shot. Because it's way more important to have Wayne Langston on the floor now with two fouls. That's two, right?
That is two.
So he's going to have to go to the bench, and the freshman Breon Sanctius is going to have to finish the half guarding Ballenboy.
Ballenboy looked awful on his first two free throws. Looked great on his next two, and on this one, it barely drew iron. Second one in the air is good. So true to his pretty much 54% average, he's hit 3 of 6. He has 3 points. Racers still up 2. 5:33 to go. 28-26 the score. Pass out top comes to Croker. By the defender. By Ballenboy. That'll be a goaltend. It was going on the rim. And give it to DeMarcus Croker, who has 6 points.
That's an explosive DeMarcus Croker there. As he turned the corner, went right down the lane, and got to the rim in a hurry.
DeMarcus outside shooting has been, let's be honest, pretty bad in this tournament, but he's hit 3 shots from point-blank range. That's what he's going to try to do, attack, and it's really been successful for him tonight. Sanglin to Ballaboy. He can shoot a three, and he got it. Front of the rim, kicked on over and goes in, and it's 30-29.
I tell you what, though, Neil, the Racers will be okay if he keeps shooting those, because that's not where he's most effective, and he can't get to the offensive glass when he's shooting from the three-point line.
38% shooter. He has 6 points. Racers up one. Seymour has it out high. Finds Moss at the point to Seymour. Left corner, Jones gets the defender in the air. Steps in for the 15-footer and drained it. 6 points for Jones. It's 32-29.
Racers having a lot of success with catching the ball, giving a quick ball fake, taking that little crab dribble, and then able to convert the shot.
Cannon with a one bouncer off to Sanglin. He looks for Baker, catches, mid-block extended, Ballaboy, trying to work on Sanchez. Got away with a walk, lost the ball. Jones in heavy traffic, behind the back dribble, leaves it for Seymour for three, no good. Front of the rim, pulled out by Ballaboy, off to Sanglin in traffic. Jones might have got away with a little bit of contact. Drive inside, up and in, and a three-point opportunity. I'm sure Sanglin is glad they didn't call the foul. Now he has a chance at three as the foul goes against the Racers, and that's going to be number three on Breon Sanchez.
I didn't see if they – did he put a two up? Did he call it on Moss? Or
no, it was on – they have it on Breon Sanchez.
Okay.
That's his third.
Okay, yeah.
Free throw by Jeremy Sanglin, 75% shooter, good. But now Weber State is deadlocked at 32. McGee will come in. Remember, he's playing with that bruised hand. They'll try to get him in for Sanchez, who's playing with 3 fouls. Croker gets by Ballaboy, trying to reverse it. Crazy pass, gets it back for an open look three, and it's no good. Tipped by Seymour, but into the hands of Weber State. Cannon left side. Sanglin leaves it for Cannon for three. It's in and out. Rebound tipped up. No good. Tipped out front. Bollum boy stolen away and kicked back into the other end of the floor. Picked up by Stanglin. To Banker, no-look pass for the stuff to Braxton. And Weber State goes up two.
You can see the type of athlete that Braxton is there. He left outside of the lane, Neil.
34-32. Matt McMahon has to take a timeout. He needs to get Sanchez out of there with those three fouls so he doesn't pick up a fourth. But the bad news for them is they do have to pick up without Wayne Langston the rest of the half. That's a media timeout. It'll turn into 34-32 our score. Weber State up back in a minute on the Racer Sports Network. Three rebounds, Cannon two assists for Murray State. Moss has 9 points, Langston four rebounds, and Jones with three assists. Each team lining it up. Weber State 58% from the field, Murray State 52%, and we're back to action with the Wildcats leading the Racers by two. Jones at the left elbow extended, finds it to Moss out top with a one-hand pass. Back to Jones, through two defenders, absorb contact from Cannon, put it up. It's going to be an on the floor. It'll be the Racers ball on the baseline. Sixth team foul against Weber State.
Bryce Jones driving that gap there, and almost Neil got that shot off quick enough to be able to get an and one, but officials made the correct call and calling it on the floor.
McKay Cannon with a foul, his second. It lobs out to McGee. Now to Jones, fakes the pass to Moss. We'll bring it out as you approach the 3 minute mark of the opening half. They shovel it to McGee. He traveled with it. Couldn't make up his mind whether to shovel it. McGee didn't believe it, but that was a good call.
Yeah, he did walk. Good call there by the officials. Racers got to get some stops here heading to halftime, Neil. They've fought, done a good job all this first half. Now playing with an undersized lineup the last 3 minutes.
Four turnovers on the Racers, three against Weber State. John rejects the screen, skip pass right side. The defender in the air and a good jumper from 18 feet. The high archer by Baker is good. And it's a 36-32 lead for Weber State. That is their biggest lead of the game. The Racers' biggest lead has also been four. Jump pass comes to McGee. Corner three, rims no good. Tipped out, knocked away, loose on the floor. Touch last, Jones didn't pick it up. I think he thought it was touch last by Weber State and he should have grabbed it.
I think he could have grabbed it too. He thought it was rolling out of bounds and touched by Weber State. Officials right on top of it made a good call.
Never assume that if you can get it. If you can get it. Weber State now with the ball and a chance to pad a four-point lead with 2:20 left in the half. Singlin leading all scorers with 11 points, has it between the circles. Left side to John Hill with the cutter inside, put it off the glass and in. Kendall Hill has five. And with Langston out of the game, Weber State able to really take advantage of what they would like to do inside. It's 38-32. The Wildcats fans across the way making noise. It comes to Jones. Inside, free throw line, looks for the fadeaway, doesn't have it. Plenty of time on the shot clock. And the Weber State bench loves the defense. Jones, a dribbling exhibition, finds Moss for three at the top. It's good.
Big bucket by Jeffrey Moss there. The Racers really needed a bucket there as the momentum was going Weber State's way, and big shot right as the shot clock was expiring.
Racer's 3 of 8 from three range. Moss having a big, big night. He has a dozen points in the half. 38-35 Weber State. Singlin at the top. Finds Baker. Fakes the pass to John. Gets it to Singlin. Looks for the screen. He's deep on the wing. Drives inside. Forced out of bounds with the pass. They said touch last by the Racers.
Yeah, the Racers tipped that. I think Bryce Jones tipped it as he was passing it through the lane.
No argument at all by anybody. So a good call by the officials. Bounce comes out high to Singlin. Left-hand dribble. Looks for room to shoot. Looks for that step back. It isn't there. Hill, down low to Ballenboy. In a double team. Fights his way. Puts it up and in. And drew contact. He'll have a chance at a three-point play.
Neil, the Racers switched that high screen there set by Ballenboy. And you can't do that with him as he rolled right down the lane. Was able to receive the pass and had an easy bucket. Now gets a chance at a three-point play.
That's the fourth foul on Breon Sanchez as they gambled, and it didn't pay off. So we'll see the first action on this road trip for A.J. Patty. The free throw is no good by Joel Ballenboy, who has 8 points, but has struggled somewhat at the line. 40-35 Weber State. Patty hands it to Colbert. Looks left side, bounce back to Jeff Moss. 15 on the shot clock, final minute of the first half. Moss looks for room, gets a screen from Patty. Steps back, top of the key, three. It's off the back of the iron and picked up by Hill. Weber State a chance to add a 5-point lead. About a 12-second differential in the clocks. Singlin works just inside the midcourt stripe, and Weber State will take a timeout with 20 on the shot clock, leading by 5.
Thought that call underneath on Ballenboy was going to be on Jeffrey Moss instead of the fourth on Breon Sanchez. That's a huge foul, Neil, for the depth of the Racers, as Sanchez has been given great minutes in a backup role to Wayne Langston, been sometimes playing them together. And so he's going to be limited now the second half on his effectiveness because he's going to be a little tentative playing defense and rebounding. And that's a bigger play than I think we know now. But the second half down the stretch could be something that comes back to haunt the Racers.
Let's see what Weber State draws up in the timeout by Randy Ray. What a success he has been there at Weber State. In his 10th season, 185 wins. They're pretty much, you want to know what they're, it's the Murray State of the Big Sky. They haven't been around as much, the Big Sky 1963, but 21 championships by Weber State. Singlin dribbles right side, has Hill wide open, didn't want that three, down to 3-2, and they're not going to get a shot off, or do they? No, side of the rim, they did, just in time. Final 9 seconds of the half. Colbert will bring it across, down to 6 seconds. Colbert to 4 seconds. Top of the key, three by Colbert, rims out. And the rebound by Weber State. Our score at halftime, Weber State 40 and Murray State 35. Remember, the Racers have trailed at halftime in every game of this tournament. And in the two that were decided, they are 2-0. We'll see if they can do it a third time. Back with our halftime summary, our Murray Electric stand summary and more after this timeout on the Racers Sports Network.
Had 10 fouls called on, 10-4 was the fouls, as the Racers never got into the bonus. And so you continue that pattern the second half, and it's going to be difficult to compete.
A couple of things that it is really encouraging to see, and that is Jeffrey Moss. He's hitting shots. He's made a couple of threes, shooting the ball very confidently tonight and having to play 17 minutes. But besides him, no one else really has the hot hand, although DeMarcus Croker, he missed the 1-3, but has decided to drive it to the basket, and he's having success on a pace to pick up 12 points.
Well, I think Coach McMahon challenged DeMarcus and say, let that part of your game come, the perimeter part. Let it come later in the game as you get it used to driving, handling the ball, drive the gaps, get to the free throw line some, and then take those open shots within the flow of the offense and not just trying to jump up and take an uncontested jumper.
Jeremy Sanglin got off to a great start early with 8 quick points for Weber State. Has been limited to that 3-point play ever since. So you can't really say they did a good job on him overall. He has 22 points, but he gets them off in a hurry. And the last 8-9 minutes of the half, I thought they did a pretty good job. If they can continue to do that, then they could have some success against him. But they can't let him have 11 in the half, probably.
No, you can't. And Jeffrey Moss doing a good job on both ends of the floor tonight as he's drawn the assignment of Singlin. And offensively, this is the best Jeffrey Moss that we've seen this year, Neil, is he looks comfortable. He's shooting within rhythm. It doesn't look like he's trying to just, direct it into the basket. Now he's just jumping up and letting it fly, and his offense looks really good.
I know as Racer fans, we want it all, and we want it all now. I understand that. But at the moment, let's be honest, the Racers seem to be a big man away, because when Wayne Langston goes out, they have Breon Sanchez, who is, folks, let me tell you, he's going to be really good, but he's a freshman. He's not supposed to be able to fill that kind of a role right now. And A.J. Patty, he's a JUCO guy. Remember Wayne Langston last year? He struggled early on. It's going to take him some games before he gets comfortable playing under his belt. And right now the Racers just a big man short looking for answers. And when you go up against a team like Weber State, it's tough to get those.
Right, and it's just not Joel Ballenboy that causes problems inside as they bring in Braxton and then Hill, who are very springy, athletic 6'8" forwards that just cause a problem when G. McGee is trying to play the four and defend there. And so, as well as Weber State shoots the ball, Neil, I don't know that you can, try to change things up and play some zone, because they can just flat out shoot it from really all the positions. So I think the Racers will have to stay man-to-man, especially as long as they're behind, and see if they can have enough defensive pressure out front to not let the game get to the big guys. And that was part of the game plan, is for the Racers to have enough ball pressure where they can't see those direct passes into the post.
One other issue, and that has been the poor shot selection last night a bunch. Not as many tonight. They have done a better job with that.
It has, and moving the basketball, we talked about last time that there's a direct correlation in ball reversals and defensive breakdowns. And when you're reversing that basketball, defenses tend to break down so that then you have the opportunity to be able to drive into the paint and penetrate and pitch or either try to get a bucket.
Let's look at your Murray Electric stats summary. The Racers led in scoring by Jeffrey Moss with 12 points, 5 of 8 from the field, knocked down 2 of 3 from 3 range, 6 each from Bryce Jones and DeMarcus Croker, 4 for Wayne Langston, who was limited to 14 minutes with foul problems, but he was the last member of the starting five to score tonight. G. McGee picked up 3 points on 1 of 4 shooting, 2 each for Breon Sanchez and Chad Colbreth. The Racer assist leader is Bryce Jones, who tallied 4 assists. For Weber State, they were led by Jeremy Sanglin's 11 points. Joel Ballenboy has 8. 5 for Dusty Baker, 3 for McKay Cannon, Zach Braxton with 4, and good bench scoring in the first half. Kendall Hill with 5, 2 each for Rashad Gittins, and Cody John has 2. The leading rebounder for Weber State, co-leaders in the first half, Singlin and Ballenboy with 3 each. For the Racers, G. McGee leading the way with 5 and Wayne Langston with 4. That is a really good positive for Wayne Langston tonight. to get him up to 7-8 rebounds per game. That would be outstanding. The team shooting for the Racers, 15 of 31, 48%. 3 of 10 from 3 range, 30%. They made both of their free throws. For Weber State, 14 of 23, 61%. They've hit 5 of 8 behind the arc, 63%. They have struggled at the line, 7 of 12, or 58%. The teams have done a great job taking care of the ball. 4 turnovers for the Racers, only 3 for Weber State. They have 9 assists, 2 blocks, no steals. For the Racers, 7 assists, no blocks, and 1 steal. Points dead even in the paint at 12. But last night, remember, the Racers had 20 points off the Pepperdine turnovers. Tonight, 3 points off Weber State's turnovers. Weber State has 6 off the Racer turnovers. Murray up and second chance points 4-2. Fast break points dead even at 4. And Weber State the edge and bench points 9-4. We've had 4 ties and 9 lead changes. The biggest lead of the game for the Racers, 4. That came at the 18:37 mark. For Weber State, the biggest lead of the game, 6. That came with 2:12 left in the half. And our halftime score, Weber State 40, Murray State 35. Back with second half action after this on the Racer Sports Network. 35, Weber State. Elsewhere in the OVC, EKU beating Thomas More 101-67. Tennessee Martin 83, Harris Stowe 57. Those are finals. 5:32 left in the game. Austin Peay leads Oakland City 73-47. That's your GoRacers.com scoreboard. Ready for second half action. The Racers trailed Milwaukee 31-24 at the half. Pepperdine 28-26 at the half. Trail Weber State 40-35 at the half. Can they come back again? Weber State gets the ball to begin the second half. Balamoy lost it on the floor, touched out of bounds as Jones dived to the floor, got a hand on it, and knocked it out.
Balamoy was in the post trying to establish position and just didn't catch it clean. And as he fell, Bryce Jones trying to get into the scrum and I think tipped it out of bounds.
Inbounds it comes to Cannon. Dribbles at the top. With a right-hand dribble, bounces it to Singlin. Facing up on Jeffrey Moss. Lob to the mid-block. Turn around. Braxton left it short. Tip out. Comes to Moss right through his legs. Balamboy on top of it and throws it away in the backcourt. It'll be an over and back because he did have possession when he threw it.
Yeah, he was just on his back trying to get rid of it as Balamboy had gotten on the floor. Coach McMahon's wanting the Racer team to be able to be diving on those loose balls there. And Bryce Jones did on the first one, but the second one, a lot of Racers stood and watched.
NBA scouts love to see that. Like to see a guy willing to give it up. And we get a reaching foul called as Braxton reached over to try to poke it away. Really kind of a foul that you hate to see as a coach, but Braxton did it.
Right, and that double team was coming quickly again as Wayne Langston was about to catch the basketball.
Inside, we get another foul away, and they're called for pushing on Jeffrey Moss. And this one is going to go against McKay Cannon. And if that's him, that's number three. So there are some issues quickly, and Cannon may come out of the game. So Weber State's going to lose their point guard very quickly. And coming in, it'll be Cody John, a 6'3 freshman. Big difference there, although Cannon's a freshman too, but he's really good. Out top, McGee hands it off to Jones. Racers looking for their first point of the half. Weber State whiffing on their initial possession. Jones, right-hand dribble. Gets it away to Moss. Toss to Langston. To Jones, baseline. Fadeaway, 15-footer, rims out. And Braxton, the rebound for Weber State. Outlet far side goes to Singlin. Singlin at three range, doesn't want the three that early. To Braxton, near side, John. Lob down to Balamboy. Mid-block extended. Makes the pass across the lane. Shovels it out top for John. Side of the rim, no good. And it hit the elbow of Balamboy out of bounds to the Racers.
Racers did a good job of getting the ball out of Ballenboy's hand in the post there. And that's the difference, Neil, with John jumping up and taking that open three-pointer or McKay Cannon, who had his third foul, taking that open shot.
Jones to the top finds McGee. A little peek inside for Moss, not available. They double down on Langston, who had the ball. It's a tip. Croker just tried to make something out of nothing as the pass was deflected, but he couldn't stuff it. And the rebound pulled out by Weber State. Ballenboy tried to go inside. It'll be a kicking violation against the Racers, and it'll be a baseline toss in for Weber State.
DeMarcus Croker with an athletic play there, trying to catch that loose ball and dunk it.
Singlin to trigger on the underneath out of bounds right of the basket. He lobs it into John on the far side, back to Singlin. He'll bring it to the top of the key with a left-hand dribble. Inside, Baker rifles it into Balamboy, knocked away by Langston, and then off of Ballenboy's foot out of bounds.
Wayne Langston aggressively going after that loose ball, tipped it right off Ballenboy's feet. See if the Racers can't get something going. As Wayne Langston catches that ball in the post, the double team's coming quickly. He's got to be careful about where he goes with that pass.
Croker inside, dishes to McGee for an open look. Three left corner, no good. The Racers suddenly cold behind the arc, 3 of 11. Neither team has scored in this half. Singlin works on Moss, gives it up to Baker. Out top to Braxton to the right side. John to the mid block, lob to Balamboy. Now to Singlin. He looks for a screen, gets it. Good switch off on the double team. Finds Ballenboy, hand off to Singlin. One hands the pass to John. Goes inside the free throw line and hits the layup.
John just kept driving until it opened up and he was able to kiss it off the glass.
Biggest lead of the game on the board. 42-35 for Weber State. 2.5 minutes in to the second half. Jones leaves it out top with a one bounce to Croker. Hands it off to McGee. To Moss. Moss on the far side high. brings it to the top with a dribble to Croker. Croker got away with a walk as he went inside, took a bad shot, hit the front of the rim. The rebound pulled out by Weber State. Singlin inside. We get a reaching foul that'll be called. They will not count it. It's on the floor, and Weber State will have the ball.
Foul on Bryce Jones there. Singlin's so good in transition. He can actually move over and play the point guard when needed, and that's what he's doing now with John in the game, who's in for the freshman guard, Baker, who's got those fouls.
Singlin the trigger, left on the underneath out of bounds, finds Baker, catch and shoot, corner three, front of the rim won't go. Braxton the rebound into the right corner. Bottom boy drills it from 18. 10 points for Bottom Boy. That's a 9-point lead, 44-35, the Racers' biggest deficit since they played Georgia on Friday night. To the top, it is Croker with a right-hand dribble. It comes to Moss, mid-block. Good bounce across, shot up no good from Langston to McGee. He drew contact, and it'll be a non-shooting foul. They called it on the pass. Racers will have it on the baseline. Seymour in for McGee.
G. McGee flooded right down the lane to the basket as the double team came on Wayne Langston. He was able to get it to him.
Inbounds it comes to Seymour, to Langston in the corner. Back out top now to Jones. A screen set up for Jones. The 15-footer no good there for the putback. Langston missed it but got his own rebound and put it back up and in.
Wayne Langston stayed in it. Now this is the smallest lineup, Neil, that the Racers have had tonight, is really four true guards, and not without G. McGee and Wayne Langston.
44-37, Racers' first points of the half. Left side it comes to Singlin, hedged by Langston, gives it up to Braxton to the far side. Baker hooks it out top. Ballenboy didn't want the three. Singlin does. Six on the shot clock and a little bump. Not much by Langston, but he's whistled for his third foul.
Wayne Langston trying to get out there and blow up that ball screen. As the Racer scouting report said, when that Singlin comes off there, try to be able to just double team that and get it out of his hands, and he was a little late getting there and got the foul.
Singlin underneath out of bounds, lobs it into Braxton, to the free throw line. Baker shovels it to Ballenboy. Catch and shoot three is too hard, and the rebound pulled down by Jones of the Racers. Down seven, Moss catch and shoot, wide open three, set his feet, and that's dangerous for Weber State. It's good.
Jeffrey Moss, there's back to the Jeffrey Moss that we saw last year, Neil. Played with a lot of confidence offensively.
44-40, the Racers, five straight points to cut it down to four. On the right side, Baker comes left side to Singlin. A good hedge there by Langston. Singlin drives around it, gets it to Braxton, looks for room to shoot, doesn't have it, jump. Goes to John. John, the leaner from 15, hit it. It's a nice stroke by John, who has six. 46-40, Weber State. Jones lost the ball to Croker, shoveled it across the lane to Langston, and it's up and in.
All fake, good Wayne Langston showing that ball and getting Ballenworth in the air, and he was able to put it in.
SIU's coach would have been proud to see that, wouldn't he? 46-42 on the fake. Inside. John into the corner. Oh, they left Singlin open. That's not good. And he made him pay. It's good.
He is one that can get heated up too, Niels. He likes to shoot three or four in a row after he hits one.
49-42. Weber State back by seven. Jones guarded by Singlin. Gets a screen from Langston. Bounces it in to him. And it's knocked away out of bounds by Braxton with 15 on the shot clock. It'll be the Rangers' ball when we come back. Out of the media timeout. 49-42, the Racers trail Weber State. Back after this on the Racers Sports Network.
Now Chad Colworth in off the bench to see if he can get some open shots, try to be able to loosen this defense up some.
Seymour takes about 4 seconds to get it in, but makes a good pass to Moss. Out to Croker. Remember, there's only 8 on the shot clock. Let's see if Colworth even recognizes that. Down to 5. Langston dribbles, goes inside, underhands it, and it is no good. He was forced to shoot what he could get, and Weber State with the ball a chance to regain the 9-point lead. Lob to Hill, down to Ballenborn in the mid-block, extended, gives it up to Gittins to the right side corner. It goes to Hill again. 3, top of the key, good. It doesn't take long for Singlin to make him pay. He has 17, and the Wildcats lead is 10.
Chad Colworth turned his head, Neil, to look at the ball, and when he did, Singlin relocated, and they hit him with a pass, and he just drilled it.
10-point deficit. Croker to the left side finds Colworth. Down to the mid-block, Langston tries to dribble. They send the double team his way. Colworth drives inside, forced up a shot and missed it. And on the rebound, it's pulled out of there by Singlin. Speeds down the stripe. Bounces into the far corner. That's John. Doesn't want the 3. Lobs it into Hill at the right elbow. Faces his defender. Now throws the shoulder down. Puts the shot up. Heath shot a bad shot that time. And Langston got the rebound. There hasn't been any bad one shot by Weber State tonight. They've had great selection pretty much all night long. It comes to Croker by his man, blocked by Ballenboy, and a fast break 3-on-3. Singlin will take it in on Colworth, forced up the shot, but he drew the contact, and he'll go to the line for a pair of free throws.
Had to foul there as Singlin got baseline on the Racers there, and kept him from getting an easy deuce, but Singlin's a very good free throw shooter, and he'll have 2.
He had 1 free throw tonight as part of a 3-point play and made it. He has 17 points. If Weber State continues doing this, you're probably looking at your most valuable player of the tournament. That one is up and good. 18 for Singlin, and the lead is now 11. He has been mighty impressive. A good job, Randy Ray, a veteran coach. He's a great opportunity to rest the big man, Joel Ballenboy, and brings him out.
And at the same time, Matt McMahon is getting Wayne Langston a rest and bringing A.J. Patty in. Is A.J. obviously not as strong as Sanctius and Langston, and so with him not having to guard Ballenboy, it will help the Racers defensively.
Singlin with 19 points, 54-42, the biggest lead of the night on the board. Pass left side goes to Moss, and we get a moving pick called against the Racers. A.J. Patty, is that the call, or is it the other way?
Don't think so.
Not
I think when
way.
Moss was coming off the screen there, that Gittins was grabbed his jersey and got caught for the foul.
So it was 23, not 32. Inside, Croker drives, has it stripped away. It'll lead to a layup, slam dunk instead by John, and it's 56-42. Cody John has 8. The Racers are going to want a timeout. They got to regroup. There's time to do something about it, but right now Weber State is really feeling it, Kenny. They're knocking down shots at a 59% clip, 54% from three-point range, and the Racers simply can't stop them.
No, it's a very good offensive basketball team that Weber State has with an inside-outside approach and good driving guards. They're very balanced. They're certainly not just a two-man team with Ballenboy and with Singen.
Weber State has lost twice this season. One of those to Utah State. They're 4-0. The other one to South Dakota State. They're 5-0. So they haven't lost to anyone who's lost a game this season. It's a really good team. They have the 2 pivotal guys, but these 2 freshmen are growing quickly. And I'm telling you what, they'll be a force in the Big Sky Conference for sure.
They will, as they have been for a long time. And last year had a lot of new faces all come in at one time. And their coaching staff felt like that was just too much. They just never really could get into sync and ended up having the worst year of his career at Weber State. But this basketball team here is very strong offensively. You can tell they're committed on the defensive end as well. So they're going to win a lot of basketball games.
A little bit of history. In 1995, the Racers were sent to Tallahassee where they played North Carolina. At that same tournament, Weber State played Michigan State. I was in media overflow for Judd Heathcote's last game, and watch Weber State rally from the halftime deficit and take them down. One of the big upsets in the NCAA tournament that season. Let's see what the Racers have done to regroup. On the floor, Seymour, Patty, Croker, Colbreth, and Moss. Colbreth, top of the key, finds Moss. It goes to Seymour, mid-block. Now to A.J. Patty. He was open for a three, didn't want it. Seymour does and misses. Three-pointer off the mark. The Racers 4 of 13 behind the arc. Rebound by Weber State. Singlin has it out top to the right side. John, instructions from Coach Ray. As Singlin has it, top of the key to Gittins. Looks left side to John. Curls to the left elbow. Lifts the dribble. Bounces it to Hill. Backs down two defenders. Splits them. Shoots and misses. And it's Seymour with the rebound. Under the 12-minute mark, the pass comes to Seymour, right side. To Colbreth, left side, Croker, into the corner. A deep three from Moss, rims out, and Singlin the rebound. No one there to get it for the Racers. 11:40 left, Singlin. Coast-to-coast layup, put it up and in.
Well, the defense opened up there, and he just was really, no one touched him as he laid it off the glass.
21 for Singlin, inside. A.J. Patty gets it, rattles, no good. Got his own rebound, puts it back up, and missed it from point-blank range. I think was anticipating contact, and Singlin comes away with it for Weber State. The Wildcats up 16 with 11:14 and ticking, and they can afford to really take their time in the rhythm of their offense. Out top, Gittins has it. Looks right for John, throws underneath, wide open. We get a foul. That was going to be an easy layup. A.J. Patty with a really smart foul there. Otherwise, Jawan Williams would have had an easy layup. And that'll be Patty's first foul. Williams to the line for two when we come back out of the media timeout. With 11:04 to go, Weber State 58, Murray State 42. Back after this on the Racer Sports Network.
In if the Racers got, this is where you find out what you're made of. Neil, do you keep fighting? Do you keep clawing, trying to get back into this game? Or just cash it in and let it go? But let's see if the Racers come back with Wayne Langston and Bryce Jones. Let's see if the Racers can't get some buckets now going into the low post to Langston.
Jawan Williams' first free throw as a Weber State Wildcat is good, as is his second free throw. Both are there. Now it's an 18-point lead for Weber State, 60-42, as we go under the 11-minute mark. Jones finds Moss, back to Jones, lobs down to the mid-block to Langston, tries to back his way in on Hill, puts it up with a right-hand miss, tips it to himself, goes up and in.
Well, Wayne Langston has gotten so much better, Neil, of being quick off his feet once he shoots it, hitting that floor and exploding right back up to the offensive glass.
60-44. A 14-0 run by Weber State over the last 4-11 stopped with that shot. Singlin has it top of the key. To the right side it goes to John. He'll bring it out top. To the near side now to Singlin. He dribbles at the point with seven to shoot. Six to shoot. Singlin right side. Looks to the corner. Baseline fadeaway jumper is an air ball. That'll go as a shot clock violation to the Racers.
Racers came out 2-3 zone that possession, Neil, to give Weber State a different look. Now Weber State will come back in with their two starting forwards. So let's see if this zone might cause some problems. If nothing else, it's an opportunity for Coach McMahon to see if that's something that they want to add to their arsenal.
Now Tom Jones works the left side, now the right side. Croker cuts across the lane. Jones to the mid block, finds Langston. He's going to try to back down Braxton again. Lost the ball. Puts it on the floor. That's a double dribble. He'd already dribbled. And I don't know if he thought he, I don't know what happened, but he dribbled again.
Yeah, I don't know if he thought that the defender knocked it out of his hands and he could go get it and dribble again, but unforced turnover there by the Racers.
Racers have done okay in that category. They only have six, but they've only forced five on Weber State. Right side, John to Glitten. It goes to Singlin. Singlin hands it off to Ballenboy to Singlin. Jump pass goes into the corner. It's tipped out of bounds by Moss. Weber State has it with 14 on the shot clock.
Racers are finding Singlin in this zone so far, and they've certainly got to know where he is all the time as he moves through the zone without the ball in his hands.
Comes out, look for a screen from Broxton. Still hasn't gotten one. Down to seven on the shot clock. John dumps it down to Ballenboy. Double team, step back, 18-footer is good.
Wow, he's showing the NBA scouts here that he does have a little bit of range as he's hit three now that are right on the three-point line.
12 for Ballenboy across the lane. What a pass by Jones. It goes to Langston, and we have a whistle and a foul called against Weber State.
Not sure how Wayne Langston caught that pass as Jones rifled it from about 8 feet, and Wayne caught it clean and drew the foul.
Push as he caught it, though, on Ballenboy, so the Racers will have an underneath out of bounds. Moss lobs to Langston. It comes to McGee. We have a push called on Gittins. Rashad Gittins' second personal foul. That's six. On the next one, the Racers can get to the line, and if they can do that, make some free throws, you never know. But they're going to have to get some stops if they're going to win this game. McGee to Moss, catch and shoot, 17-footer, bad miss. Left side of the rim, barely drew iron. Weber State has the ball. John on the near side to Singlin out top to Braxton. Far side, the pass goes to Ballenboy. Excuse me, that is Gittins. Gittins to Singlin. Lob pass to the baseline. Braxton finds Ballenboy, went up for the dunk. He was about to tomahawk one, and a Racer reached in and swatted the ball away but got some arm. Jeffrey Moss guilty of the foul.
Good thing that Moss was able to reach in there, Neil, as that was looked had the makings of a Sports Center highlight,
yeah.
There as Ballenboy is such an explosive athlete, and he's got extremely long arms and big hands. That basketball looks like a ping pong ball in his hands. When it gets around it, he is quite a physical specimen.
Just a junior, and if he will work and if he can improve his free throw shooting, I'm telling you, he is going to be something else. He has a lot of skills. That one's up and good. It's one there. Ballenboy now with 13 points. He is at 4 of 9 at the line, though. It could be much better. Thankfully, if you're a Racer fan, it isn't. 63-44, 19-point lead. And we get a foul called on DeMarcus Croker. That's the second time he's pushed off.
Marcus Croker get a little frustrated there. And that's what's difficult is trying to make that play early in the possession before the defense gets moving.
Racers using full court pressure. But Singlin does a good job getting it into front court. Finds John on the right side, now to the left side. Touch pass to Ballenboy at the left elbow. Gets it out to Gittins for three. Barely drew the bottom of the net, and it's out of bounds to the Racers.
Racers zone, actually, Neil, has done a decent job the last five possessions they've been in it, but they got to be able to score on the other end to cut this lead.
Handoff goes to Croker. Right side rocks it, finds Moss. Left side to Jones. Look for the jab step, goes inside. Langston had a shot blocked, goes up again and banks it in. 8 in the half, 12 in the game for Wayne Langston.
Wayne Langston is battling. He's certainly not giving up.
63-46, Singlin knocked away briefly by Jones, and then it was between the legs of Singlin. DeMarcus Croker reached in and got him on the arm, and he's picked up his third personal foul. That gets us to a media timeout. 63-46 the score. The Racers trail with 7:47 to go. Back after this on the Racers Sports Network. Moss instead? Is that what they called instead of Croker?
I bet that's what it was.
All right. Free throw, no good. Well, no doubt it was a foul. It'll come to the Racers. Jones hands it off to Colbreth. Somebody's got to get hot to come back and win this thing. Colbreth left hands the pass to Moss. Down to 7.5, a 17-point deficit. Moss to Jones. Back to Moss. Looks for Langston. They're now fronting him. Moss inside, puts up a bad shot. Hit the backboard and nothing else. And Weber State gets the rebound. Ballenboy off to John to the far side of the court. Singlin wants it, and Colbreth is on him. 7:10 remaining. Singlin near the mid-circle. Left side, dribbles. Gets it away to Baker. Baker inside Braxton, put it up, missed it. And a foul on Langston will be his fourth.
Wayne Langston was late getting around in the post, and once Braxton was able to catch the ball, he had his hands out over him and instead of straight up, and just really it was all he could do to keep him from making the bucket was foul.
Racers, two of their last 13 from the field, and that is not the formula for a comeback. At the line, Braxton misses the free throw. Just a 59% shooter. Has 4 points. Moss checks out. Langston comes out with those four fouls. But Matt McMahon will need them back in for a stretch run, and they'll give it one more try to try to come back and win it. Both free throws missed, so the door open to get a little closer for the Racers as Jones comes across. Top of the key, drives inside left hand, off the glass and in from Jones, and it is good. He has 8 first of the half. 63-48. Full court pressure, jump pass goes Singlin to Bottomboy. Now to Baker, back to Singlin. 6:38 remaining. Singlin to the right side to Bottomboy. Comes out to get it. There at that hash mark on the far side of the court. Finds John inside the mid-stripe. Gets it away to Singlin. Back to John. He traveled. Good call there. Hampton was right on top of it. Shuffled his feet before he dribbled.
Racers back man-to-man, trying to cause a little havoc, Neil, defensively. See if they can force some turnovers and try to edge back into this game. Deficit of 15 points. Wayne Langston with four fouls. Let's see if the quick guards can cause some problems.
Jones inside, right corner. Head fake on the three from McGee, doesn't shoot it. Gets it back to Jones. Now McGee rejects the three, goes inside, tried to rifle it into the corner to Seymour and threw it out of bounds.
G. McGee jumped up in the air on that, making that baseline pass with just nowhere to go with it, and unforced turnover.
John in the backcourt to Singlin. Double team. They get it across with 3 seconds to spare. Singlin works on Colbreth. Bounces out near the near side. It's John. Comes to the top of the key with a dribble. Jump pass to Singlin. 10 on the shot clock. Weber State eating a bunch of clock. Singlin looks right. Wide open. Baker gets by his defender. Puts the shot off the glass. No good. Bad miss. Seymour the rebound. Racers need to make some shots and get them up. McGee to Seymour. Couldn't get the three off. Out top, McGee rejects the three. He will drive in. Drew contact. It's an on-the-floor foul. And the Racers will get the 1-1.
G. McGee likes that quick ball fake and then driving to the basket. And if he can get to the point, Neil, where he drives to that basket, comes to a jump stop and goes up and shoots, I think he's going to be much better off. His officials are just not going to bail out players as they're driving to the basket and looking to get a foul called.
Singlin with his third foul. John comes out of the game. Braxton checks out of the game. We see Hill back in. And also coming back in, McKay Cannon. McGee at the line, a 74% shooter. Remember, he has the bruised left hand. Puts the shot up and it rattles in. First free throw of the night for McGee is good. He has 4 points, 63-49. 5:28 to go. Can the Racers get a comeback win? They're in a deep hole now. Lot to dig out. That would have helped, but it rims out. Second free throw is a miss. And it's pulled out by Weber State. Into front court. McGee goes for the steal and instead drew a ton of contact and pick up his second personal foul. And it'll mean free throws for Weber State. That's the ninth, so this will be the last time Weber State will have the simple bonus from McKay Cannon. He hasn't attempted one. He's a 75% shooter.
McKay Cannon back in after getting that early third foul in the second half, and now gives Weber State two very good ball handlers, and with Cannon and Singlin in facing this Racer pressure.
64-49. Weber State 55% from the field in the game, 50% from three range, 7-14. Haven't shot the free throws real well, 13-22, 59%, but those other shooting percentages could be very forgiving when you do that. The next shot is up and good, both free throws made. Dead heat on the rebounds, 28 all, 8 turnovers for the Racers, 6 for Weber State. They lead the Racers 65-49. 5:13 and ticking. Langston back in with those four fouls. Hand off to Seymour, who fell down. He's on the floor battling for it. It'll be a possession arrow ball. It'll stay with Murray State. He simply lost his footing. Well, if it's a possession arrow call, it should be the Racers' ball. That's where the arrow is pointing.
Right.
They do have to come out and take care of some perspiration on the floor, so they will do that.
Wayne Langston back in for the Racers, along with Chad Colbreth, DeMarcus Croker, Bryce Jones, and Justin Seymour.
Racers need someone to hit some threes. That is Seymour putting it up. Bad miss. Barely drew the left side of the iron, and Weber State gets the rebound. 65-49. The Racers very cold from three range in this half. On the far side, it is Cannon. Cannon gets it away to Singlin. Mid-block, tosses it out top to Cannon. Cannon with the dribble, under 10 on the shot clock, drives inside for the soft touch jumper, missed it, and high to get it, DeMarcus Croker, out to Jones, 4:30 remaining. Racers down 16. Jones goes in, drew contact, and it'll be the 1-1 for the Racers.
Bryce Jones still battling there, trying to put a little pressure on the defense in transition as he's very capable of doing that. See if he can convert now at the free throw line.
Cannon's fourth foul. And he's going to come out of the game. Cody John will come back in. We had a Johns last night, a John tonight. And at the line, Bryce Jones has hit his only two free throws tonight. He has 8 points. 5 assists. That one is up and good. Jones has been a very good free throw shooter. 65-50. Weber State, its biggest lead 19, a chance to cut it to 14 here. Jones takes his time and it pays off. Both are good. 10 points for Jones, 65-51. Singlin gets it to John. Back to Singlin. Looking to set a trap on him, but he's able to get it across, and it's stolen by Colbert. Colbert hooks it and threw it away. He wasn't looking. He had to kind of throw it before he fell out of bounds, and it's off the hands of Jones, and Weber State comes away with it. Tough break for the Racers. That could have really built some momentum. Instead, Baker has it out top. It's a handoff to Hill, knocked away this time by Croker, and it is out of bounds. That'll get us to our final media timeout. 3:59 remaining in the game, 65-51 Weber State. They'll have the ball when we come back out of this timeout on the Racer Sports Network. Handing out the ballots for the all-tournament team. And folks will be filling those out soon, I guess. Racers out of the timeout on defense. 12 on the shot clock for Weber State. Left side three is on the way, and it is good from Dusty Baker. Hit an early three. That's his first since, but that's a big one. And it is 68-51. Weber State. Colbert gets by his man, throws up a wild shot. Out of bounds off Weber State's bottom boy. It'll go to the Racers with 3:37 to go.
Racers still battling out there, Neil, and just not getting anything to fall offensively.
Not at all. Into the corner it goes to Moss. Comes out top to Colbert with a left-hand dribble. Back to Moss. Lobs it down, mid-block extended. Langston backs his man in. Looks for the left-hand hook, and it rattles in. What a move by Langston.
Wayne Langston with that left hand touch has really improved. You know, you think about where he came from when got a dead ball here with Ted Valentine stopping the play. But you think about where he came from when he arrived from junior college and just quite turned into a good offensive player.
Looking for a timeout. Let's see if it's a timeout or if it's an out-of-bounds call. They said, nope, timeout by Singlin, who was falling out of bounds and got the timeout in time, according to the officials.
Two officials right on top of the play, and they conversed and said he could take the timeout, keep from turning it over.
So the timeout leaves Weber State with two. The Racers have two. But the deficit at 15, and it's just a night when the Racers, who've been so good defensively in the tournament, haven't been tonight. And a lot of that is credited to Weber State. They've been so solid inside with Ballenboy attacking, Braxton also with 5 points, and then Singlin with that devastating touch from the outside. They've had some other players knock down some threes, including Ballenboy. And 8 threes tonight to just 4 for the Racers. That's one of the big differences in the game.
It has, and Jeffrey Moss hasn't been able to get off the floor much the second half. You know, chasing Singlin that whole first half. He looks like he's worn down a little bit. He had 12 first half points and only 3 the second half, and really not many shot attempts.
Only 3 Rangers have made a field goal in the second half. Wayne Langston has 5. 1 for Jones, 1 for Moss, and that's it. No one else has made one. Langston with 14 points and 8 rebounds. Moss leading the Rangers with 15. Jones has 10. Singlin still leading Weber State with 21. Ballenboy has 13. He needs a rebound to get a double-double. He's sitting on 9 right now. Inbounds, it comes to Singlin, and the ball was knocked out of bounds. They said Weber State may have stepped on the line when they touched the ball.
Racers in a 1-2-1-1 strap trap with Wayne Langston on the ball, was ready to come trap, and they threw it away before the ball could be inbound.
Still fighting hard. Lob pass comes out to Langston. It goes to Croker. A 3 is up and no good. That's been the story tonight. But the rebound, Jones got the loose ball and put it up and in. Ballenboy was battling Singlin for it and lost it. And it's a 68-55 game. Singlin across the stripe, across the lane, shoveled to Ballenboy, and he stuffs it in. And we get an official's timeout. Oh, we have an injured player, Colbreth. Looks like he turned an ankle, and the official timeout is to get Colbreth out of the game.
He had a collision over there as Wayne Langston went down. Colbreth fell over the top of him as they were scrambling in the backcourt on the press.
70-55, Murray State down 15, 2:48 to go. Croker into the far corner, finds Moss, looks for the lob to Langston. They have him covered up with Ballenboy Frunigan. Now to Jones, crossover dribble, looks for room to shoot. Croker inside for the stuff, missed it. Kicks off the back of the iron and comes out to Moss. It did get rimmed. Step back, 18-footer by Moss, and it's good. Moss with 5.5, 17 in the game. The lead 13 for Weber State, 2:21 to go. Probably too much time or too little time for the Racers to forge a comeback. We'll see. Singlin gets by his man and hits the layup going coast to coast.
You don't normally see such a great shooter as Singlin also be able to handle that ball, as he can play the point without any problems.
72-57, Moss at the top, looks for the step back shot, doesn't have it. McGee, you can tell he's really hesitant to shoot the three tonight. Inside, it goes to Langston. He's used his dribble. He dribbled again, might have double dribbled there. I don't think that was touched by the defender, and he hooks it up and in. Strong move for Langston, 72-59. 16 for Langston, Singlin in the backcourt. Racers not in a spot where they can afford to trade baskets. The throw gets away from Cannon, but he's able to chase it down before it goes out of bounds. I have to really find myself hesitant to root against Cannon, but I'm not used to doing that. On the far side, Weber State trying to chew some clock. Singlin, top of the key, 3 on the shot clock. Deep 3 by Hill, barely drew iron. Rebound to Jones of the Racers with 1:10 to go. Jones into front court, looks into the far corner, Moss. Down low for Langston, kicked out of bounds by Hill. It'll go to the Racers underneath.
You know, Joel Ballenboy is as nice of player as he is, Neil. He's having a tough time guarding Wayne Langston when the ball gets entered.
Croker Lobs it out to Langston, back to Croker in the corner. Sidesteps his man, goes up, and missed it off the front of the rim. Just couldn't get it to go down. Looked like DeMarcus was hesitant to think of dunking or laying it up, and it turned out it didn't go in. And now the Racers down 13, and Weber State has the ball. Final 47 seconds to go. Singlin, guarded by Croker, looks for space. Down to 12 on the shot clock. Racers have been told not to foul. That's the reason they're not doing it. Comes to Singlin left side, into the left corner. Baker for three, hit it.
Well, Baker has shown that he can make those open threes, and when you have a guard like Singlin that can drive the basketball, he's going to get quite a few of them this year.
Came into the game hitting 15% from three range, and he's buried three of them tonight. That'll help the average. Jones tries to answer with a three, doesn't get it, and now it'll be a dribble out, I would assume, for Weber State as they are going to take the championship of the Gulf Coast Showcase, and they have certainly earned it with a decisive victory tonight over Murray State. Your final score, Weber State 75 and Murray State 59. Murray State University's Racer Radio Network broadcasts are produced by Neil Bradley, the executive producer Steve Harrell, the chief technical engineer Jeremy Wilkinson. Tonight the studio producer was Bill Harley. Any use of the descriptions or accounts of this game without permission from Murray State University is prohibited. The final score, Weber State 75, Murray State 59. Stay tuned for the Murray Bank postgame show coming up next on the Racer Sports Network.
all tournament teams. Now the Wildcats celebrating in front of their bench to across the floor and to my left as the Wildcats came down here, defeated Central Michigan 63-60, and then came on strong. They defeated Drake yesterday in the semifinals 74-58 and defeated Murray State tonight by a score of 75-59. And it was a tournament of runs for the Wildcats. That 12-0 run really got them back in good stead in the game against Central Michigan. Then yesterday against Drake, they were down by 5 early, only to put together a 15-0 run to take control of that game. And then here today, leading by 4, they put together a 14-0 run to open up an 18-point spread and eventually winning this game by 16, 75-59. Taking a look at the team statistics in this game for the Wildcats, 24 of 46 shooting for 56.5%, 53% from three-point range, 9 of 17, 61% from the foul line at 14 of 23. For Murray State, just 40% from the field, 25 of 63, 4 of 16 from three-point range, and 5 of 6 from the foul line. The Wildcats, for the most part, the more aggressive team going to the bucket, and that's why they shot 17 more free throws than Murray State. The Wildcats were outscored in the paint, though, 28-22. Weber State turned the ball over 8 times, leading to 5 Murray State points. They forced 9 racer turnovers, and the Wildcats scored 13 points off of those. Murray State did a good job on the offensive glass with 11 offensive rebounds to the Wildcats 3, outscoring Weber State 16-4 in second chance points. Wildcats were able to push it to the point where they had 10 fast break points to Murray State's 4. And again, the Wildcat bench with 17 points to Murray State's 4. So taking a look at the individual numbers, the Wildcats were led by Jeremy Senglin, 8 of 9 from the field, including 4 of 5 from three-point range, 3 of 4 for the line for 23 points, 6 rebounds, and I'm sure Jeremy certainly put together the kind of an event here in which he probably will wind up with the MVP. He scored 18 in the opening game against Central Michigan, 34 against Drake yesterday, and 23. Joel Ballenboy with his 6th consecutive double-double, 15 points, 10 rebounds on the night, and Dusty Baker in double digits with 11. After that, Cody John with 8, 5 for Kendall Hill, 5 for McKay Cannon, Zach Braxton with 4, 2 points for Jawan Williams, his first as a Wildcat, and Rashad Gittins with 2. For Murray State, they were led by Jeffrey Moss with 17 points, Wayne Langston with 16, and Bryce Jones with 12. After that, G. McGee with 4, Breon Sanctius with 2, Chad Culbreth with 2, Justin Seymour and A.J. Patty played but did not score. And the Wildcats taking control in the second half after a tightly played first half that saw 4 ties and 9 lead changes. Wildcats win the championship of the Gulf Coast Showcase by a final score of 75-59. We'll have much more from Florida right after this here on 1430 KLO. to Germain Arena, where the Wildcats have won the Gulf Coast Showcase by a score of 75-59 over Murray State. Right now they're introducing the all-tournament team. Wayne Langston, who was on the Murray State team, who had 16 points tonight. He was on the team. Cale Abrahamson from Drake, who had the big 41-point game earlier in this tournament. Joel Ballenboy has just been announced as a member of the all-tournament team. Joel combining in this tournament to score 46 points. And he also pulled down, 37 rebounds in this game, in this tournament. So a big effort on the part of Joel Ballenboy. And also now they're going to introduce the final member of the team, of the all-tournament team, and he's also going to be the tournament MVP, none other than Jeremy Senglin. Jeremy Senglin combining for 75 points in this tournament. Senglin also pulled down 15 rebounds along the way. Some spectacular shooting, 12 of 18 last night from the field, 8 of 12 from three-point range, and tonight 8 of 9 from the field, and 4 of 5 from beyond the arc. And so the Wildcats getting some post-tournament honors as well as winning the championship. So just a moment, they're going to be handing out the second place trophy and then the championship award here at Germain Arena as the Wildcats take the title overall. Now they have a record of 4-2, while the Racers also drop to 4-2. So the Wildcats now receiving their championship hardware that they'll take back to the D Event Center. Again, the first time that Weber State basketball has won an in-season tournament since they won a tournament on the Big Island of Hawaii back in 2001. So a great effort by the Wildcats. They were swarming all over the floor, very aggressive, setting screens, helping one another out. We talked to Randy Ray about it in the pregame, the fact that you've got the guys like Ballenboy and Senglin who will put up the numbers, but it's the guys away from the numbers that really help you win basketball games. Obviously, you can't do it without the numbers guys, but obviously some of the play of guys like McKay Cannon, Dusty Baker, Kendall Hill, Zach Braxton, even Cody John, who is was activated off his red shirt last week. He was a very confident player, I thought, early on in this game that really helped, actually early in the second half, I should say, as he helped the Wildcats build that lead that eventually extended out to 19, and they won the game by 16 by a final score of 75-59. The ceremonies still ongoing here on the floor at Germain Arena as the Wildcats gathering around, a lot of friends and family and even a couple of coaches with their cameras taking pictures and watching the guys celebrate on the middle of the floor here in Estero, Florida. The Wildcats will come home with the championship. Again, we hope to talk to Randy Ray when we get an opportunity here in just a few moments as the Wildcats are able to come away with the championship here in Florida. So it'll be a nice flight home on Thanksgiving morning